Hi, another week for Janet Russell Presents The Daily Blue. Well, we had so much to talk about.
Fantastic time.
Last week that we decided to have my friend Stefano. Why do I keep changing your name?
It's hard. The other and fastest on the other syllable. Stefano.
Stefano. And I have a friend of mine with the same name. Actually, he goes under Stefan.
Yeah.
And I said, no, you have to come back. We have to do a second show because we have so much. We could probably do 5 shows, 10 shows with this young man.
Thank you so much. He has so much going on.
And I so appreciate you coming back on the train and the whole deal. So when we cut off last week, we were talking about some of the clips that you did.
Yes.
So we're going to have them on this week now, the clips, you know. Do you want to talk a little bit about that?
Sure. So one of the clips is a film called Animal. It went to the Chelsea Film Festival.
Okay.
It was official selection. It's a crime thriller of an ex-cop who is trying to look for this guy who he could never really catch with enough evidence. He ends up kidnapping this kid and interrogating him, and the story goes on from there.
You're giving me chills. It's almost like a true story.
Yeah, I feel it because
if I get chills, it's confirmation.
Kelly Beam wrote it, directed it. I found out about it from Liz Veda, who works for HBO.
Interesting.
Who recommended me to audition for this, I was super lucky.
Yeah.
You never know what happens. The universe is very mysterious. I went in to audition for an episode of Girls, got a call back, didn't get it, but somebody from HBO recommended me and said, Stefano, you might actually be good for this part.
And
this is the clip Animal. You'll be seeing this clip. It's I'm now caught. I'm in the woods. The actor who plays the old man, I don't know if you know him, Russ Camerata.
Oh yeah, he's on the show.
Russ, unbelievable actor.
He's on the show.
Russ, unbelievable guy.
Yes.
Unbelievable talented actor.
Yes.
And you see this little clip where he's carrying me, just making me follow him through the woods. So it's a little bit of drama there.
He was on cable on the other show.
He's a good guy.
Real nice guy.
Next
clip
will be a clip from In Parallel. That's the film that's going to Cannes this year.
Ooh.
It's going to premiere May 18th, 2016 in France at the Cannes Film Festival. It's a.
We have to bring you back again.
It's a Northern Irish story. I have a Northern Irish accent, and it was great to do that. I had like a dialect coach work with me for like 2 months. It was a lot of work.
Did you wake up at night during the night saying, "Oh wait a minute, look at that, just perfection"?
Well, no. You start off reading books and you think about what you want to say and how you want to say it.
And after
a while, you stop thinking about your accent and you just say what you want to do. But probably one of the lightest ones to do, one of the lightest, funnest accents to have. You feel it. You feel.
Interesting.
It's
interesting.
And so I had a real, real dialect coach.
And you can understand it too. That's the good part.
Yeah, absolutely. And you want to make it light. You know, some actors I see in movies, I think that they're so. The acting becomes about the accent, and it's not. It's just an aspect to color it.
Right, exactly.
And that film is about a love story. Parallel is a love story about two people meeting each other in difficult times in their life, and they fall in love.
That's
going to be going to Cannes, so you'll have that clip there in Parallel. Mm-hmm. And the last clip you'll have is a film from Immunity, which is a World War II film. Which is a film that I worked with Rena Sofer, who is an Emmy Award winner from Bold and the Beautiful. She's on the Bold and the Beautiful now. Yeah, and I was the lead there. It takes place, it's a period piece from the 1942, Auschwitz.
Oh, that would be interesting. Ooh.
Very intense.
Had to be.
Very intense.
So what have you wrapped up recently?
That was the last film.
Last
this
one.
Is the
okay.
most current clip that you'll have.
Fabulous.
Wrapped it up at Gold Coast Studios.
Okay.
Loved shooting at Gold Coast Studios. They were shooting.
I've never been there yet.
It's
huge.
Huge. They were shooting. Keanu Reeves was there shooting the sequel to John Wick.
Okay.
But it's unbelievable soundstage. Unbelievable. I think it's in Bethpage, right?
Yeah, somewhere
like that.
Yeah.
And we had to completely design the soundstage to look like, you know, every piece of furniture and the clocks and the table, the stencils, the pens.
What's her name? Corey, did she help you?
Corey was definitely on the set design. She's great. She was unbelievable.
She works a lot with Donna, too, Donna McKenna.
Yes, Donna McKenna, another person that we know and love.
Yes, I love her.
We love Donna McKenna.
Shout out to Donna.
Best casting
director. She is. She got me in as extra in a couple of movies, and I love her. She's been on the show a lot.
So. Another person of heart.
Oh, totally. Gives more than she'll ever get in her lifetime. There was something I was going to ask you now. I forgot. What would be your ideal role? If you had a choice, like you asked me before, who would be my ideal, you know, person to meet in the field? What would be your perf? In other words, if somebody said, all right, Stefano, I'm changing your name again. we want to write something that you want. What kind of role would that be? I mean, it's a heavy duty question, I know.
I really love characters who have two aspects. I love good people who do bad things.
Ooh, so that's different.
Absolutely. I love seeing characters who are maybe not caught in the best circumstances, but they're good people. Because I think in a way we're all like that.
Well, do you think the aspect of that, do you think that
there's a humanity
good that they want to just taste the other side of reality? What do you think?
I think that life,
or something they won't get caught in.
Well, some of it is that, yeah.
They're
shoplifting at Whole Foods or whatever. They're stealing stuff and they're going around.
Meanwhile, you see them blasting out their phones.
I love cat. I just
too funny.
I think it's because
it's that little kid in you coming out.
Yeah, well, I think all of us are a little. You know, all of us. Are a little, all of us are good and all of us are a little bad.
Well, that's what makes us unique.
And I think what is fascinating to me as an actor, artist, you know, call it whatever, that I like characters who are flawed, and I like characters who are fundamentally good people who find themselves doing bad things,
making
bad choices.
Yeah.
The layers of those human beings is much deeper.
Oh,
There's more going on, and to me,
you can't see this.
It resonates with me more as a human being because I identify with that very much.
Interesting.
The second thing that I love is I'm fascinated now. I'm doing a film that's in production coming up in Thursday.
Okay.
We start shooting. It's a Belgian film where I play somebody who's blind.
Interesting.
And impediments of any kind to me are fascinating.
You know, I have a friend of mine, she's a graphic artist and she's deaf, and I read her all the time.
Really?
She's great. Yeah. Actually doing some stuff.
And also how her senses probably change too.
Yeah. But I've learned to, you know, like I know her for quite a few years, and now when she comes, I can understand more because she used to just write down the questions. Now it's like, okay, all right. And then if I don't, she'll just write it down.
Wow.
But it's funny how you acclimate yourself to that, you know. We need to take another commercial.
Okay.
Sorry.
That's all right.
We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Tim Stead from Star Communications. We're a marketing support company. And if you need help with your next marketing project, please call 273-1900 or you can go to our website, starcommunications.us.
I hope you enjoyed that commercial, because I sure did. Well, here we are with Stefano.
Stefano.
Stefano, got
Stefano,
it!
Stefano, we got it!
I have to congratulate you. I heard you just finally became an American citizen.
I did.
Yes.
I did, July 20th.
Ooh, perfect.
I am very proud American.
Yeah, and you should be.
Very proud American. I've seen a lot of this country, but I've driven cross country twice, so I really wanted to, you know, I had to check out the landscape before making the commitment.
Let me see, do I really?
You know, I had to be on a long date. You know, it's been a long, been in a long relationship, me and America, before I was like, okay, let's do it. Let's get married. Funny.
So you know, but I also understand that you speak two different languages.
I do, yeah. You know, I grew up, my mother tongue was Italian.
Okay.
So I grew up in a very small town in Treviso. My dad was born in Italy.
Okay.
Both my parents are Italian, grandparents. And then when I was a kid, we went to Montreal. So we were speaking Italian at home, first language Italian, going to school in French.
Oh, interesting.
Watching English TV.
But isn't French very hard to learn?
French is a very super, super difficult language to learn because it's got a lot of exceptions.
Yeah.
It's got a lot of exceptions in it. But I think that having that perspective as a kid made me see that how malleable you could be with languages.
Okay.
It gives you a different perspective of like seeing
exactly
a part of yourself.
Yeah.
How you change when you change in a different language.
Very,
you know, certain languages like Italian to me feels very warm. It reminds me of my childhood.
It is that romantic thing.
Yeah, it's like
a love thing.
La nonna, sai che ti parla italiano, sei ti senti molto più comodo, ti senti più.
I have no idea what you're saying.
No, I mean, You feel more comfortable.
Okay.
You feel coccolato. You feel loved.
Yes, yes. That's one thing about it. Yes.
It's a very warm language. Mm-hmm. Quand je parle français, c'est une langue très avec beaucoup de nuances dedans. You know, it's a language with a lot of nuance. It's a cerebral language
but
to me.
But they both sound like songs.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, when you listen to it, it's so smooth, you know?
Yeah.
It's very, very smooth, they both are.
Yeah, they both come from Latin. And that has a huge influence. And that affected me for sure in the way that being aware of my own culture and then being a bit of a mismatch or a bit of a
little bit
of everything.
Yes, exactly.
Like a soup.
That's a good way to say it.
Like a soup with all the different ingredients.
Throw everything in.
And that really influenced me. And then moving to Manhattan was like,
oh, that's like a whole new world.
You know, I moved to New York when I was
Manhattan.
Super, super young. I've spent all my adult life here.
I love New York. You know, I go there, I'm like so intrigued. I'm like, what would people live here? Wow, that'd be just such a fabulous, fabulous place.
Yeah, I still feel like that.
Do you? Well,
I still am in love with the city.
You wake up at all times and you have something going on.
Yeah.
It's not like, well, I don't wait till 9 o'clock in the morning, you know, I can just, you know, here, out here, you got the 7-Eleven open, you know, 24/7, anything else, forget about it. You gotta wait, you know. I want to ask you, you know, when I have a lot of my guests, I like to give them a reading.
I'm so excited for this, yes.
And prior to us, you know, starting the show, I said to Stefano, I'll get that one day. pick two stones now, two packets. Now you
I picked two.
Yeah. Now you don't. You didn't know what the stones.
I had no idea whatsoever what was in these stones.
And I always tell people when I read them intuitively. But we're gonna first start with your birthday. Your birthday is August 3rd.
August 3rd. Do you need the year?
No.
Okay.
No. All right. So first thing, you are a Leo. My oldest boy is a Leo, and you'd be the three. I find three people are very spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I see some of the things that you put on Facebook where I feel it from your heart.
Yes.
You know, whatever you write there, because, you know, when you look at something, you know, I look into the depth of it, okay? So can I tell you that you're going to be doing a lot more work this year? Oh, God, I got confirmation from those on the other side. When I get chills, it's confirmation. When I see the hand, when I look at you, I see a hand connotes to me a lot of different opportunities coming, okay? But it also connects with finances, thank God, but also connects with travel and money.
Wow.
And opportunities. Here we go with the chills again. It's amazing how I get the chills. It's so weird. It freaks me out when that happens to me. See, I'm still in awe of what I do.
It's a beautiful, it's a gift.
It is. Honestly, it's totally a gift. So, you have people on the other side protecting you and watching over you as well. I'm going to go out on the edge when I say this, but I have to say this. There is also some famous, you may have never even met them, but there's also some famous author or movie star that is behind you, watching you, and leading you down the road.
Wow.
Now, I've never said that to anybody before.
Wow.
But it's almost like you have those angels watching around you, and they're protecting you, and they're basically... they're giving you the option to move. Oh, there we go again with the chills. To move forward. Now, another thing I'm feeling around you. Now, this might be so off the wall, but you heard it here first. You heard it here, folks.
This is beautiful, by the way. Okay.
Oh, thank you. Very. I see you doing a lot of commercials.
Hmm.
I don't even know if you do any. Yet?
When I first started off in my career, I auditioned for a lot of commercials. I'm repped by Paradigm, Doug Keston. Mm-hmm. I have a commercial rep.
Fabulous.
Paradigm agent, good agency. It's something that I'd love to go get back into, but yeah.
Now this sounds so, it just comes from above. I don't know why, but I'm feeling like you're going to be doing a commercial with children.
Wow.
Almost like the teacher, like bringing the child in, or something like that.
Wow.
It's all there, and it might have something to do, like we were talking about animals and horses before.
Wow.
I don't know. It's like everything's going to fit together.
Wow.
It's amazing.
Well, I love horses, and I love kids.
Well, there you go. Maybe you might end up, we may know somebody that works at all.
Yeah.
Horse. Hint, hint. All right, so now...
Our director here is very connected to horses. Yes. So we're feeling it.
All right, so I'm going to read you stones, okay?
It's beautiful, by the way. I just want to tell you, I had a pleasure being on your show for 2 weeks, and it's been
an amazing
experience.
Well, anytime you want, I always tell any of my guests, because I really kind of handpick my guests, not that I don't want everybody on, but I'm very, I've got to feel that connection.
Yeah.
It's either got to be there or it's not. If it's not, then I reset it, whatever. All right, anyway. This was your first packet you picked, okay?
Yes.
So I don't know if you can zoom in on that or not, but okay. But when I get these stones, I actually get them not too far away in Freeport, and I buy them by the pounds,
yeah.
And these are my giveaways. When I do my readings or my fundraisers, I always feel I like to have somebody have a little bit of a connection, and this is the connection. So when I look at these stones that you picked, the first packet, okay, to me, clear is love. So you have an enormous amount of love there. Okay, you see all the clear in there?
Absolutely.
Okay. So to me, that shows me club, love, okay? Now, you also have very light purple. Purple is, to me, a connection with those on the other side.
Right.
So you have, like I said to you, you have a lot of angels around you, okay? The green, to me, the green is a healing stone.
Mm.
So if there's someone around you or you need a healing of some scenario, you've got that, okay? Now, the tiger's eye, to me, connotes, that's a wild word. That shows me financial gain.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got the tiger's eye there, okay? But now you've got some black in the tiger's eye. To me, black is not a negative. Black is an opportunity, like the ending of something, but the beginning of something else.
New.
So when I read these stones, and I like to turn them over because since they do come from the earth, okay? Okay, so again, we have, now this is like a, I think it's citrine.
Citrine?
That's what they call it. Now, citrine from, you have seen it, see the yellow
citrine's
there?
Citrine's a self-purifying,
It's an opportunity, in other words, it's a cleansing, but it's also very intuitive, and it's also moving forward. So that's your first packet, okay? Now, your second packet that you got, okay, again, lots of love around you, okay? We've got the healing again, but you see the biggest one you got, I usually get amethyst, but where I buy the stones, he did an event in Arizona, and all the amethyst was on the truck. So I said, you got to give me something that's purple. So this is purple, okay? It's a deep purple. Oh, you see that?
Mm-hmm.
So the purple is the protection from above, from those on the other side that have left you, you know, the words that passed over, you know. So when I see this is the biggest stone here, it shows me you have a lot of protection from above. But I also feel, for some reason, were you ever connected with any artists, you know, or were your parents, you know, prior, in other words, prior to you even being born, was there some family member that was connected in the acting field or directing or, you know, musical or
there
something?
There is one, my great-grandmother, who I knew.
Okay.
Who I knew up until I was about like 7 or 8 years old. Okay. She was a painter.
Okay.
And she went to lots of painting schools like Sorbonne in France.
Yeah.
She was in Vienna. She would paint posters for her father's theater company. She would paint.
Well, there you go. See, now I had no idea.
She's the only artist in the family, and I still have her paintings in the house.
See, but see that's who's on the other side. I don't want to say forcefully pushing you.
Margherita Maria. Bisona
so,
Margherita.
But you see, it's amazing how they come through. You know. Do you want to ask me any questions?
Yeah, I wanted to ask you, tell me again what the green is. The green is
healing.
The healing.
Green, you know, the healthy healing, that's the way. Yeah, so you have a lot of green, which is telling me that if somebody in the family or, you know, or someone you know that you're very close to may be going through, some sort of a health issue or needs a healing.
Yeah.
It's there.
That's beautiful, Janet.
Oh, yes. Yeah, so
that's
welcome.
Really, that's really, really beautiful.
You're so welcome. Well, we are coming down to the end of the show, I believe. Am I right, Sam? Okay. So why don't you again tell the audience, and I so, so appreciate you making 2 trips out here. I know it's not around.
It's been
before,
a pleasure.
You know? Why don't you tell the audience how to get in touch with you?
You can reach me through email at D-A-F-R-E, that's Da Fre, my last name, at hotmail.com. Website, which is www.sdafre.com, sdafre.com. You can reach me through my booking agents, Paradigm, Doug Keston at Paradigm, or my legit agent at Frontier, John Shea. He's my agent for legit stuff.
Well, everything's legit with you, my God.
Yeah.
Come on, now let's not let that little boy come out of you again.
Yeah. So I. What else? What else? Other ways to get a hold of me? You can through Janet.
Yeah.
Janet and I
I'm
see each other.
Get
a hold of me anytime.
Though.
Yeah. If Janet says you're a good person and she likes you, then okay. I'm happy to hang out, talk to you, whatever.
Well, thank you.
I live in the city, and I'm so happy to have you, Janet.
Oh God!
So happy to be here.
I am so thrilled that you came back here.
Yeah.
It makes my heart feel good. You know, you're such a blessing. See, guys, I'm Silva Cougar. They know me. They know
me
right now.
They know you're beautiful.
Thank you. And if you want to contact me, you can email me at rosebudsjanet@msn.com. You can call me at 631-654-3353. I always tell people the best time to call me is like between 9 and noon. I'm usually around. And then after that, you have to answer to my, you know, on my voicemail. Or you can check my website. It's janetrussellpresents.com. And we will be back next week. Or actually, next week we're going to have you on. You know, this is the second week. Yeah, next week we'll be back on again. That's right. With another great guest. So keep tuning in to the Daily Blue. Keep checking up on us. And my mantra for this year is, we don't have yesterday, we don't have tomorrow yet, we only have the moment. So make your moment count.
All that stuff about your old man, that's all true? Yeah. Speak up.
Yes.
Must have been rough.
What the fuck would you know about it?
I know some things. So how far are we? Look, I can walk around these woods all day. I got comfortable shoes and a bottle of amphetamines to keep me going.
Sound out of breath to me, old man.
Yeah. even breathe, to be honest with you. I always tell everyone that my wife died in a car accident. That's not true. She didn't die in a car accident. She died in a car bombing 5 years ago in Bangor. In one day, I lost everything. And I thought, that's it. I'll never be another human being again. I'll have to pretend for the rest of my life.
Define immunity.
Immunity places a person free from legal obligation under criminal law.
Good. And possibly quite even fitting. But may I have another definition, please?
The state of not being susceptible, the ability to resist disease.
The ability to resist and remain unsusceptible. That will be the purpose of our work. You must know that every last Jew will be exterminated.
Sei italiano?
Sì.
Bravo, anch'io. Allora, puoi metterti la divisa di lavoro qui? Puoi anche fare un spuntino, But just don't let Laura or Vito catch you, because then we're both in trouble. Deal?
Okay.
This is the extra locker. You got everything in here. Shirts, ties. You're gonna be working with pasta, so you're gonna get dirty a lot. This is gonna be your best friend. Any questions?
No.
You're gonna be okay.
Thank you.